Hello everybody, I'm going to explain the dynamic routing Lapsit. So what we have so far is you should have completed your network structure. So looking at the diagram here, you should have this already and you should have the correct IP addresses for all of the virtual machine involved, and you should be able to ping neighboring machines. So from 0 to the host, from the host to 1 and from 1 to 2. So what we'll do today is we'll set up routing so that you can ping every virtual machine in the network from anywhere in the network. What we need to do first is we're going to be working on the Prometheus machine first. We'll set everything up here, get it to work, and then we'll move on to everything that we need to do on the Prometheus 1. So on Prometheus, we'll start with installation. First of all, make sure that you have internet access, of course, so make sure that you can ping Google. Once you do, then you just type yum install quagga. It will go through the installation process and it will install the required packages that it needs. You then need to go to Moodle and download the contents of the folder routing tools. In fact, I can show you this here. So if we go here, 23rd of November, you'll find the folder routing tools. Inside there will be two files, zebra.conf and ospfd.conf. These are the example files that we will need in order to get our routing working on our host. So once you have downloaded these, you need to save them in etc. quagga. So if you go to places and go to computer, you can go to the etc folder, and then if you press Q, quagga will show up straight away. So we have zebra.conf and ospfd.conf. So I'm going to explain zebra.conf first. So perhaps this is not a good way to do this. I'd rather do it in a terminal because I can make the letters bigger. So etc. quagga zebra.conf. So we have the host name, which is Prometheus, and what we have in zebra.conf is we need to declare all of the interfaces that we will be doing our routing on. So in our case, we're working on virtual machine vPrometheus, and we've started VMnet 1 and VMnet 0. So that we have internet access on our other virtual machines. In fact, if I open another terminal, it will make better sense. If you type ifconfig, then the network cards that exist here are essentially ENS33, and which takes you to the outside world, which is the NATed network card, and then you have VMnet 0 and VMnet 1. So these are the ones that need to be mentioned in zebra.conf. You have internet interface, whatever the name is, and then the statement multicast underneath it. So once you've made sure that this is correct, you can then edit the ospfd.conf file. So ospfd.conf file is the file that controls the routing protocol that we'll use. So we're using OSPF, open shortest path first. Okay, and we'll need to tell the computer which networks we're advertising here. Again, if we go back to our ifconfig, we can see that we have networks 192.168.40.0, because this is 40.137 on a class C subnet mask. Right, and then we have our internal networks, our VMnets. So we have VMnet 0 and VMnet 1 with 148.107.30.249 and 148.107.31.249 on a smaller /29 subnet mask. So our file must have the router ID, which is the IP address of your Prometheus machine. Then it will need to have the network address of the network that takes you to the outside world. Although I can, spoiler alert, this won't really work anyway, but I just like to be consistent with the configuration files. It won't work because I'm NATing to the outside world and you cannot route behind the NAT and expect it to work. Yeah. So the most important bits in this file for us are those two lines, networks 30.something and 31.something. So my network address, according to the subnets 2.net file, is 248. So I'm sharing my network address for subnets 30 and 31 in this file. Okay, so zebra.conf for the network cards, ospfd.conf for the networks that you want to advertise onto your little network. So let me quit this. I haven't made any changes. Now, once my files are both correctly configured, what's next? Disable the bridge on VMnet 0 by typing the command. So if I ps-ef pipe grep VMnet, I will see all of the VMnet processes that are running on my computer. I will see that I have VMnet 0, 1, 2, 3, because these are the ones that I created when I run vm underscore subnet. Okay. And we can see that we also have a bridge on VMnet, running on VMnet 0. Okay, VMnet bridge 0. We don't need this to be here because this will mess with our routing once we implement it. So, kill minus 9, we need the process ID of the process that we want to kill. It's this number here. So, 3523. 3523. Enter. If I process again, I can see that the bridge is now gone. So, this is what I need to do for this. Okay, so process ID is the little number, the number of the process on the second column here. Once I do that, I've gotten rid of the bridge that I didn't need. You can also do IP tables minus capital F, which will flush your IP table, so it will delete any firewall rules that you might have. And then we need to enable packet forwarding by typing the sbin systemctl IPv4 forward command. A way to make sure that this command has worked is to actually cut a file, to see a file, which is in proc sysnet IPv4 IP forward. So the contents of this file should be 1. So when this file is 1, it's enabled, so packet forwarding is enabled. When it's 0, it's disabled and it will not work. By default, Linux comes shipped out of the box with packet forwarding disabled as a security measure. Okay, and you need packet forwarding so that the operating system has the ability to receive a packet in one network card and forward it onto another network card according to what its routing through Quagga will tell it to do. Alright, so now that we've configured our system for routing, we can go and test it. My preferred way of doing this is opening as many tabs as I need in a terminal and typing whatever I need in them. So tab number one for me is zebra-f etc. quagga zebra.conf. You run it, nothing happens, you get back a prompt that occupies the window and that's it. In the second terminal, in the second tab, you type ospfd-f etc. quagga ospfd.con. And I have a typo in the labsheet, so I will correct this. So once you run OSPF here, you should straight away see all of the routing information that gets exchanged with any neighboring routers. Little information at the moment, and perhaps very even less for you as well, because when you set this up, you will not have set up the Prometheus 1 as a router. I have, and it's exchanging information between Prometheus 1 and the host. Alright, but this should be doing stuff when you're pinging. Then you have a third terminal, which you type watch root minus n. So this is showing you a live snapshot of the routing table on the computer. So, for example, I can see on my computer that I have a neighbor, I have a network here that is not, doesn't belong to me. It's the network 32 dot something, because I have 30.248 and 31.248 connected on Prometheus, but I don't have a network card with 32.248. Okay, and as you can see, the metric of this is 20, so it's two hops away, so it's after another computer, after another router, out through interface VMnet 1, which means that on my network diagram, in order for me to access anything on subnet 32, I need to go through VMnet 1, two hops away. So this means that network 32 is here because I am running routing on vPrometheus 1, and this is the new information that appears here. In a similar way, on vPrometheus 1, you will see network 30 appear, even though network 30 is not directly connected onto it. And that's what all this business of routing is all about. We run routing protocols and routing daemons so that we can have routers talk to each other, update everybody's routing tables with all of the information that they need in order to be able to access networks that are not directly attached to them. Okay, so now that I have this and it seems to be working, I can test it quickly because I can go to Virtual Machine 0, for example, and I can try to ping Virtual Machine 1. So looking at my network diagram, I am on 30.250. I would like to ping 31.250. All right, so let's start. So ping 148, 197, 30.250. First of all, can I ping myself? I can. Can I ping my default gateway, 249, which is VMnet 0 on the host? I can. Can I also ping 31.249, which is another network card on the same host? I can. And then can I ping 31.250? I can. And 31.250 is VMnet 1 on Virtual Machine 1. So because of routing, I've managed to ping further away than the next computer that I'm connected to. So now I can ping from here to here, and of course I can ping from Virtual Machine 1 to 0 as well. Alright, so routing is working on Prometheus, everything is great. We can go to vPrometheus 1. Slight hiccup with this, the problem that we don't have internet access behind a NATed network. So if, for example, you're working on a dual boot scenario at home, you can make it work. So you should be able to have internet access. So you should just be able to go onto Virtual Machine number 1 and ping Google, and it should do it. And then you can do yum install quagga and it will work. Okay, that's after you've done routing on your Prometheus actual physical dual booted operating system. Yes? If you are working on a virtual machine because you're working with versions with methods 1 or 3, you will need to have routing somehow inside vPrometheus 1. The easiest way for me to do this is to basically share with you the entire Virtual Machine 1, because everything is installed and the configuration files, the example configuration files are there. So you can basically just go onto this link, download vPrometheus 1, extract it, replace your existing vPrometheus 1 and use it. So what you need to do is you need to download it. It will go to your downloads folder or wherever it goes. You can save it in VMware, extract it, and replace your existing vPrometheus 1. Once you do this, you will need to, of course, start up the new vPrometheus 1 virtual machine, and you need to go into its network card settings and make sure that the IP addresses for network cards ENS33 and ENS36 are the correct IP addresses for your network, okay? Because at the moment when you download it, it will be configured for my computer and it will be configured to 31.250 and then 32.249. So all you need to do is you need to go here, set up your IP addresses, and that's it. Something that usually happens, and students complain about it, is sometimes you'll have all the IP addresses correctly, but it will still not work. Sometimes it's totally random. The second network card will start first. Once that happens, then the routing table on vPrometheus 1 will not have 31.249 first. It will take as a 31.250 as its default gateway out of ENS36. And of course, that's wrong. Okay, so if you think you have all of your IP addresses correct, but you're still not getting any routing, I would suggest that you disable the second network card, wait a few seconds, and then enable it again. Okay, once you do that, then your first network card, DNS33, will have taken priority, and you should be good to go. So, installation of vPrometheus 1. Everything is the same. The only thing that changes are the configurations that we do in our Zebra.conf and OSPFD.conf. So if I go to places computer, and I go to etc., I press Q, find quagga. If I look at my zebra.conf file here, I forgot, of course, yes. So let's make this bigger. VI zebra network.conf. Network cards involved. The network cards in the virtual machine are not called VMnet 0 and VMnet 1 anymore. Yes, they're called ENS33 and ENS36. Bonus is that they will all be called ENS33 and ENS36, and you don't actually need to change anything in this file. You do not need to edit zebra.com. Okay, so we have the names of the network cards, and then we edit our ospfd.conf. And what we have here is we have the router ID and the networks that are directly attached onto it. So for my computer, my virtual machine 1 has an IP address of 31.250 and it's connected to networks 31.248 and 32.248. So I need to share those two networks with the routers around me, which in this case will be Prometheus. So now that I have this in place, I can start routing. And it's the same process again. So one terminal with Zebra minus F, one terminal with OSPFD minus F. You can have the routing table in root minus N, and you can have another terminal so you can ping stuff and do whatever you like. The way to test this is to actually go to virtual machine number 2. Make sure that you disable the firewall in here as well with IP tables minus capital F. All right. And of course, it goes without saying that, you know, whilst you're repeating the process of installing routing on one, you have to enable packet forwarding and disable the firewall as well. Yeah. So now our test will be to see how far we can ping from V Prometheus 2. So if we look back into my network diagram, I'm sitting on 32.250 on V Prometheus 2. So I'm going to try to ping myself first. 250. Can do it. I can try to ping my default gateway, 32.249, so I can get out of my computer, and then I can try to ping 31.250, which is another IP address on the computer next to me, and I can. And then of course I can try to ping 31.249, and I can do it. So this particular step means that routing on V Prometheus 1 actually works, because I can ping past it. Of course, it goes without saying that I should now be able to also ping 30.249, and our last target for the day, ping virtual machine 0. So I can ping all across my network because I have two routers in place in between my two furthermost computers that allow packet forwarding and route the packets correctly onto the network. Okay, so this is the final test that everything is actually working. And the last thing that you need to do, now that you know that everything is working, that your services are working correctly, you can actually stop them from running in debug mode in the terminal, as we said, and you can type systemctl restart zebra.service and ospfd.service, so that will start the service as a service running and not taking up terminal. And then of course you can check config them on, so that they can start automatically every time you start your computer. Of course, you need to remember that we need to do IP tables minus capital F every time you start a computer. You need to make sure that your firewall is not in the way. All right, so this is pretty much it. There is a bonus round, of course, as always. Can you ping anything outside your virtual network? So this doesn't really apply to all of you that have dual booted the system, okay? Although it might, depending on your home, how your home router actually reacts. I want you to explain why you cannot ping the outside world from your virtual machines, even though you do have routing in place. All right. And even better, if you can make them ping the outside world while retaining the networking structure, infrastructure on the inside. So I do want those public IP addresses and those custom connections on the virtual machines to stay there. If you can make it work, that will be extra marks for you. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much.